this is going to be the final part.
During this stay.
Yeah.
thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to give a series of lectures. This was very helpful to write a grant proposal and also collect several parts. I hope this is no stupid mistake. But if you notice something, please let me know. And first of all, reference last time I wrote this. This is Rogalski J.J. Sen. this is simple. advanced mass. And what I explained, ring theoretic motivation and so on are all contained in this paper. So if you are interested in, please take a look. And this part, actually today's talk, it is today's talk is logically independent, so don't worry if you are new. And let us start from definition. And everything for simplicity, I walk over C. And X is a smooth projective, projective variety. And sigma is automorphism of X. In this case, sigma is called wild if closed, Zariski closed. This implies this whole space. In this case, we call sigma is wild. And today is my last lecture in this stay. And I'd like to talk about this theorem and its proof. Theorem is that if dimension x is less than or equal to 3 and there exists some wild, then either X is an abelian variety or X is this is actually trivial. I found this and this is an analytic topology. This is and is zero entropy. This is in our context, this is the same as maximum of absolute value of eigenvalue of action on this is 1. And this theorem is motivated by their conjecture that if projective variety admit wild automorphism, then it has to be necessarily abelian variety. That is their conjecture I claimed last time. And this case, what is the problem I can explain in the proof? So this is the theorem. And
even in dimension 2, you still have
a second positive. Sorry, x is just threefold. Thank you very much. So up to dimension 2, everything is fine. And so from now, I'd like to explain how to prove this. And this remark I already make last time, but there are some new audience. So. This case, no irregularity. What? Sorry. Yes. conjecturally, this does not happen, but. And one remark is, once we have these examples, then we can go to universal cover. That is still Calabi-Yau threefold. And we can lift sigma. And as I explain soon, this will be, again, wild. So we can reduce the problem for simply connected case. This is true. As a statement, maybe this is more precise. So first of all, x must be always smooth because stable. So this is not assumed everywhere. And also sigma is wild. This is equivalent to, there is some number such that sigma n is wild. And this is also equivalent that maybe this is non-zero. All these are equivalent. This is almost clear. If not, then we have some, then this is almost same as positive or negative. Then this is sigma stable. So in this, and the other part is almost the same, and you can find by yourself. This is zero means this is identity. So, thank you very much. yeah. Thank you very much. This is. Thank you. That's what I should talk. Okay, and this is. Also, I explained last time. Quadratic dimension is necessarily non-positive, and also, if this is zero, then kx must be linearly equivalent to zero. This is by you can consider the action here. And this is just like Pn, and usually we have fixed point, and the fixed point correspond to a stable divisor and contradiction. And this is very important observation and also given here. This is if some wild action, then holomorphic Euler characteristic. This is necessarily zero. This is very actually they don't use this very well, but we use this very much. And I can explain why this is true. And last time I made some confusion. And this is essentially reduced to holomorphic left sets, but this is very so we consider this space, and here of course we have wild group. This is okay. Wild group action, and then this is a characteristic polynomial of the action here. This one can write like this is one. I don't know. One can write like this. And what we learn in first year linear algebra is Kelly Hamilton's theorem. I forgot last time Kelly Hamilton. This is this is so this is zero. So, so this is zero. And on the other hand, this is plus minus determinant. And this is automorphism. So this is non-zero. And we have this. So then restrict this to HI, restrict to this HI, and take trace, restrict this equation, and take trace, and we take this, then what we get? Trace. K H I. H I O X, and L is 1 to K. Plus trace identity is just H0 or X. We have this equation. And then take a sum now from I is zero to dimension of this equation, then what we get? This is K C L. X. This is I zero to dimension X plus C zero, and this sum is nothing but holomorphic Euler number, and this is zero. But here, I'm sorry, here one important thing is that if sigma is wild, then this is also wild. Then this must be empty. Fixed locus is stable. This is empty. But this part is nothing but holomorphic holomorphic left set number of the action sigma. And this is now empty. So this is zero because this is empty. And this is some precise formula, but without formula, anyway, this is empty, so nothing appeared. So this part is zero. So finally, this part is zero. And C0 is not zero, implies chi OX is zero. This is the idea of proof. And this case, I use this for holomorphic version because I use more this from now. But exactly same argument, applied for here. Then we have exactly for the same argument, topological Euler number of X is also zero. We can just modify this part, holomorphic left sets to topological left sets, then essentially same argument gives this. So something strong restriction, non-trivial strong restriction appears. And next, next is also very, very nice result. And this is again R, three authors observation. And here, if, so this is one of the characterization. And such that iterate, assume that this iterate is contained in identity component of the automorphisms. Then X is an abelian variety. This is and one remark is that if this is trivial, this means a dimension zero. If this dimension zero, then this means this is identity, but cannot be identity. Wild one cannot be identity. So this condition already implies that this is positive dimension. And this is also not so difficult, so I can explain how to prove. So replace assume because conclusion doesn't depend on this. Conclusion doesn't involve this, so I assume this. And Then consider the group generated by this and take Zariski closure that is inside X. And probably take identity component. And I put this is H. Then this is algebraic group. And this is commutative, so Zariski closure is also commutative. So and zero component is commutative, and this is commutative. We have this group, and I choose one point x. I choose one point x, and consider. A morphism H goes to orbit of this H. Then of course this considering again Zariski closure of image inside here. Then this is because H is sigma stable. So this is again sigma stable. So, so this means X must be closure. And of course, if this is proper, if we know this is proper, then this is already almost done. Anyway, this is not so bad space like KSI projective because linear part or abelian part. So anyway, this image is on the other hand, so this is constructive inside X intersection with closed and open. But Zariski closure is whole space. So this means. This means closed subset only this set and there exists some Zariski open subset we can find. Zariski open subset inside X we can find. But then Because tau H is by definition of this, so orbit of this, and U is inside here. So this is, again, same as this space. But this is open. This is open. So this is open. What I'm and U is inside here means U is of the form H times element of H times X. So even if we make another H, this is that does not change. So this is open. This is open. So this means this is open means this is closed. And this is sigma stable. So, so this implies X is certainly this space. And then I think almost. So this means tau. This is subjective. And also this is because X a stabilizer group of point to Y. This is same, here H is abelian and transitive. Abelian and transitive. this is same as and so all stabilizers are the same. So tau is injective. And both are smooth, so this implies. And this is projective, so this is projective algebraic group, and this is abelian. This is abelian, but this is some characterization of abelian varieties. This is and probably this is one of the motivation, also motivation of their works. Now, this case is almost clear. I don't use anything, but if I use this, then chi x is zero, so this implies x is elliptic curve. because smooth and second dimension two. This has two cases, two possible cases. We divide into two parts. And in this case, kx is q linearly equivalent to zero, and kappa is zero. And already, if one allowed to use classification theory of surface, this already implies x is abelian surface or hyper-elliptic. We get already this. This is classification. But hyper-elliptic surface, again, if you have some familiarity with surface, this has exactly two vibrations, exactly two vibrations over P1 and over Albanese. And this is a smooth vibration, so does not match information. So this is exactly two. and different image. So this is now sigma stable. But here, good things is we have sorry, then I can find a much easier proof. So, so now we have this surjection, and sorry, I don't need any, sorry. And this is, if this is wild, and we have also action here, if we have also action here, then this is again wild. This is because if we have some stable subspace, then play image is stable under this, and this contradicts wildness. So this must be wild, but P1 cannot have wild, because dimension one then only elliptic curve. So there are several ways to discuss. And actually, we can say a bit more. This is some proposition. This is abelian variety goes to x, and this is eta. And we have this wild action. We consider this. This is looks like this situation. Then x is x itself become abelian variety. This we observed our joint work, and the reason of this one is Bob use precise form of Bogomolov composition theory, part of Bogomolov composition theory, and I also use for threefold case, so I state here. This is in Katata's series, and this form is very useful to study automorphisms. This is smooth projective and any dimension. Then Bogomolov composition is well known that there exists some ethereal covering from abelian variety times some Calabi-Yau, which is simply connected, and also some hyperkähler manifold, and this is eta. And because the fundamental group is this part is just finite, so we can make all intersection of conjugate, we can make this galois. And slightly non-trivial, but this part is identity component is zero, automorphism identity component is zero, and this part is Albanese. So using such a things, all automorphism is divided into, this part is also divided, but not necessarily. This kind of diagonal description we always get. And so inside here, we have translation automorphisms, just translation. But because of this form, translation we make no translation part. This is always possible because translation part is normal subgroup and just divided out this part. And we have this kind of precise form of the decomposition, but also and this is unique up to isomorphisms over X. So under this assumption, we can always find this kind of ethereal cover, but this become a unique one. So conclusion is that then all F to X tilde. So this is a very useful part, and I use several times in my study of Caribbean. And once we admit this one, then, then considering, this is this coupling is called minimal splitting cover. This is minimal. If we have this, then goes to minimal splitting cover. We have some lift and we obtain this kind of diagrams. And this is now Galois. And of course, how to say? This is Galois. Galois means this is G. And then, like this. So replace. Some multiple. We can always make commutative for all element. Because this is finite. Then this is a very strong condition: finite group, and commute with A, and this A is also wild because this is wild. And I had no time to prove. The structure theorem of wild automorphism of abelian variety. I just stated last time. And using that structure theorem, one can show the following. This is not very difficult. This is a proposition. And this is Kilson. He's some PhD student of, I forgot, that A is abelian, and sigma is wild, and G is finite group, and if we have these conditions, then G is necessarily contained in the translation automorphisms. This is, I don't know how you, I think this is not so trivial, but proof. Uses structure theorem of wild automorphism of abelian varieties and consider this condition into two parts, translation part and re-automorphism part, and using induction on the dimension. Using induction on the dimension, and he obtains the result. In order, yes, I can give a proof if I have a time. A trivial subgroup is translation.
Okay. Sorry.
And this is the conclusion. Yeah. And so from this proposition, from this proposition. So this proposition implies G above is identity. Because minimal splitting cover excludes all translation automorphisms. And so this means A is abelian. This is proof. And this is something about Kodaira dimension zero case. And kappa is minus infinity case. Theorem tells that this doesn't happen. So we want to show impossible. So I'm sorry, from now, argue by contradiction, so nothing remains after proof. So assume otherwise. This already shows, and this is this part is H0k, and because of this is zero, and this is one, so this is one. So this already shows that we have Albanese map. We have Albanese map, and sorry, I forgot. this in this setting, so wild automorphism is, in my feeling, that this is nothing special happens. This is some feeling about wild automorphism. So any bad things we worry about never happen. This is a good thing. So, for example, this has smooth vibration. Because singular fiber part is preserved by sigma, and this contradicts wildness. So this is smooth. And so here, this is kappa minus infinity. And this is elliptic curve. So fiber, generic fiber is P1, but all fiber is P1. P1 bundle over elliptic curve. And three authors' paper, then they enter a very detailed study of this P1 bundle over elliptic curves, but I think we don't need this by using their result. And this is P11, and this we have wild one, and this is Albanese map, so this descends to here. This is again wild, and so this is just a translation of infinite order. Because this is elliptic curve. No unipotent B automorphism except identity. So in this case, because this is P1 bundle, so minus kx, this is F1. And this is sigma stable. And Also, L is very ample, sufficiently on C. Then, this is ample. Ample on X. And point is that now this is translation. So this is same, but in Meron 7. And so this is, if I put this H, we have this, and ample 1 is fixed. Then, then this, if you remember, I give in my my first lecture, the component containing a finite Riemann. This is because Hilbert polynomial. Hilbert polynomial of graph and this is something like X and this is just finite remaining just one possibility. So this is finite remaining. So this implies that there exists some n0 such that this is certainly inside in, zero component. But then, as before, X is abelian surface, and this is contradiction. Because we are assuming kappa z minus infinity. And surface case, we can finish in this way. And maybe I have still time. Just a moment. Okay. Then threefold case, I'll give last lecture. Okay. All three, but I'm a bit afraid I can finish one. Sorry. Sorry, this is essentially only the proof, and, but I can give some program in the middle. Then continue, and now. And again, we must consider two cases. And case one, as before, And we have a minimal splitting cover. Around the home. Elliptic times K3. This is a strict Calabial, 3-fold to X. And this case, as before, the proposition says that X is A. And this case sigma extend to here, but this extended sigma is as I just cite in the Bobby Holmes way. This is a diagonal action, and this is wild. But then, this is K3, so not wild. And so contradiction, a question. Why I did not go to fourfold is like this kind of things may happen in consideration. So at this moment, I did not really. And the last case is somehow should understand the case what we should understand. And case three, at least we have this is finite. So H1OX is zero. Then zero. This implies positive, but this is H0kx. So in this case, what this is and why this is true? Why this is true? We want to show this, and to see this now, I use topological Lefschetz formula, topological Lefschetz formula. And here this is wild. Here this is wild. So as I observed before, this is all empty. This is all empty. And then consider topological Lefschetz. Then this must be zero, and this part is now this is Calabial, so. This part is just 2, and minus This is degree three part. Plus H4. This is a formula, but this part is positive definite, because, and this part usually we don't know, because if H1 still remain, then Hardreff says that this times ample class and the other part is decomposed and this is positivity here. But in our case, this is zero. So already this part is now negative definite. So this part eigenvalues. All absolute value one, and totally this is defined over G. Defined over G, so this is also algebraic integer. This is a positive definite with respect to the intersection form. So this is orthogonal. This is unitary. Sigma star omega times sigma star omega bar. This is omega bar, but this and this is for the same reason. This part is again intersection. Eta bar. This is the bar, and this part is. 2-1 plus 1-2, so usually not necessarily definite, but Hardreff says that.
In the first case, you have just one measure.
Yes. This part, we have several element, but here I use. Hardreff sets H21 plus H12 is usually H10 plus. Because definite and this preserved Hermite, this is Hermite definite, so this means Hermite in a product. And so inner product is preserved means this is unitary with respect to this inner product. And unitary matrix eigenvalue is always absolute value one.
So you decompose this negative part.
Yeah. And this each part is preserved and out. This is positive and negative.
No, but this decomposition is not over G.
This decomposition is not over G, but over R. So each part absolute value of eigenvalue one because of the unitary. Each part is absolute value one, but totally, this action is given by H3 times coming from this decomposition. And action is already defined over G. This action already defined over G. So all eigenvalue must be algebraic integer. And only here. If not primitive, then we can take this kind of ample one and plus orthogonal and decompose. But now this part, this is not preserved by sigma, so we don't really. sorry. This is essential part, and Carapia is very lucky part. So. Actually, this is one of the part of which I'm very worried before. So this implies this is all.
No.
Yes. So all root one. So after replacing sigma by some multiple, this part is all trace b to x minus b 3 x minus 3. We may assume this because after the minus or yeah. So this means and so please may I assume by replacing sigma by we may assume this, and then eigenvalue of I wrote down this as this is mutually distinct, and this is multiplicity. Multiplicity. Sorry. Then trace of this trace is on one hand minus plus. This is B 3 X minus 2. On one hand, we have this, but this is nothing but by this description. M1 alpha 1 n plus ms alpha s n. So this number is always become this. But what this means? This means if we take n is 1 to s, then alpha 1 s, alpha s s, M1, MS. This is all this is all X. And then next take plus 1. But this is, if we make this same matrix, then we can just multiply here alpha 1, M1, alpha S, MS. And this is same. But this is invertible. Van der Monde. This is invertible. So this implies so all one. I think this is okay. So this gives entropy is zero.
You mean they are parallel, huh? They are parallel, but
No, this is how to say
but you have two
solutions. No, because this is an invertible matrix. Uh-huh. Invertible matrix has only one solution. Uh-huh. No?
So not only entropy is zero, but all animals
are one. After some reduction. Yes. Yes. You are right. Thank you very much. You can solve. this is now what I want to talk. Yes, exactly. And sorry.
In the previous case, if there is invariant polarization, then
here one problem is, of course, we cannot find ample polarization, invariant ample polarization. If we have invariant ample polarization, then it is.
But all line values are invariant. No.
This is action on H2, and all eigenvalue is 1. But this is not diagonalizable. Because if it is diagonalizable, this means some invariant ample. But if we have invariant ample, then it is finite, because discrete. So we are happy. Yes. Only unipotent. And some authors say that from this one can find rational Neff vectors, but that person's proof is completely wrong and nothing is written down, but I can prove it, at least. And this implies that we have some integral Neff class V such that I can show this later. Soon I can show this. And so this is on X.
And
this is non-trivial, I think. Yes. Thank you. Yes. And in that case, if then for the same argument as before, because this is a projective space, and this contradicts wildness. And From this to this, this is a big question in Calabria in general. If we have, this is just to say, knowing distance as I remarked before, we can make Calabria simply connected to passing to the universal cover. And simply connected Calabria, we have some integral neck divisor, non-trivial. Then, whether or not it has a member or not, this is a big question. And when I was young, I considered, but I could not solve completely. I give some partial answer, but I could not solve completely. So this part is a big question. And but at least we can fix until here. And I can show how to prove how to get this from that information. And this is we consider the action on h to xz, but this is and all Calabria. And inside here, after tensor, we have Nefcon. This is a strictly convex. And of course, the action of sigma preserved. In such a case, this is Heron-Frobenius. This is completely linear algebra. This is some finite dimensional vector space, and inside here we have some strictly convex cone, and interior is non-empty interior. Then, Heron-Frobenius theorem says that there exists some, one can always find eigenvector, and this is, no, not necessary. Not necessary. Any value. this is max eigenvalue of this. I wrote d1 sigma. This is in general. This is absolute value, but as a max. As a result, it is really eigenvalue. inside here, such that d1. We can always find this. But here, there is one problem, because this is, we go over Nefcon, and inside Nefcon. So even if this is rational, for example, rational case is only, one is only possible rational case, because this is algebraic integer. But Nefcon looks like this, and eigenspace, maybe some looks like this. And this V is intersection between this and this. But this point, we don't know really rational vector or not. because ample nephcon just intersection, so this does not give the, actually this is rational or not. And so what we reconsider is as follows. Yes, one can always find eigenvector in the nephcon, but in general it is real. And what we did is, so anyway, we can make a Jordan canonical form. This is, one can make this over rational. One can make, because all eigenvalue is rational, one can make Jordan canonical form over rational. And this is maximal, assume this is maximal size. We take this maximal size part. So otherwise, equal to this or smaller than this. And then considering, then sigma star is something like I plus N. This is because maximal size is k plus 1. So this is just stop like this. We make. And so we consider mk. And of course, if m goes to infinity, then this is goes to mk because other part is degree smaller than m, smaller than m, k, smaller than k. So we have this. And so, and this is a general ample. Considering general ample one. Then this is, of course, in this stage, this is still ample. Because this is automorphism. And then take limit. Then this is limit of ample. So this is nef, and but because of this one, this is on the other hand nk times h. And because ample class is open, so this is not zero if this is general. This is ample one is open. And but this is clearly rational. This is clearly rational. Rational class and nef class. And this is also preserved by sigma. And this is preserved by sigma star. Because this goes to just n plus 1. So these three condition is nothing but this condition. This is because amplicon is open, and NK H is 0 means H is kernel of NK. This is non-zero, smaller space. So in this way, at least we can find something, but still this remains very big program to eliminate Harabial case. And but I think now maybe this is only the problem remaining part, and from now I enter the case of what time is this finished? 5:20, okay. And the dimension 3 and the from now we need to consider more, but I cannot. maybe you can. because I'm.
No.
Because actually I'm afraid from the beginning this kind of things certainly appear at some place if we consider this kind of problem. But and I. Yeah, and now consider this case, and what we want to show is that this is unrealizable. Of course, we should eliminate this case. And again, this is important information, and three, and this is this is and this I this is so this is zero. So from here again we have irregularity positive, so then we can consider Albanese map. X goes to A inside R. In general, this is sigma and sigma. And now, this is threefold and kappa is minus infinity. So this must be covered by rational curve. So this implies this must be less than or equal to 2, and this is wild. These two conditions imply that A is abelian, because dimension less than or equal to 2 case we already settled. So this means from the beginning we have and irregularity. This is 1 or 2. This is setting, and also because this is smooth vibration. And the case. So fiber dimension smaller is looks easier. In this case, we have and this is smooth P1 fibration as before. And here we have wild one. And if this is translation, then just as before, plus this gives a contradiction. As before, this gives contradiction. But now this is two dimensional, so this is not necessarily translation. And otherwise, this I just state last time. This is translation and real automorphisms, and this this is nilpotent. We have this situation. And under this situation, we don't know some good invariant or not. And this is actually infinite order, so I think no such things. And but now I consider and of course, this is non-zero. If this is zero, then this is just translation. And in this case, taking something, C is kernel of beta, and take identity component. Then this is elliptic curve by dimension reason, and this is not necessary. Sorry. Okay. And then I consider this A. Sorry, notation is slightly difficult. We have this, and because this is still preserved by sigma, so we have sigma, and this is elliptic curve. And this part is minimum elliptic ruled fibrations. We have this situation. Again, this is everything is smooth. Everything is smooth. We have this. Then what I can say? This is maybe I wrote pi, and this I wrote maybe E. And now, we want to find from this part, we want to find some sigma stable sub-varieties. This is what I want to do. And in this case, this is pi, so as I said before, considering, sorry, maybe it is better to state from this. This is I need for but I if you know this is already written in the literature, please let us know. This is S is minimum elliptic. Rule the surface, then this is always non-negative. This part is I did during my stay, and in this case, if kappa. Then from this to this just Zariski decomposition, considering base locus of this, this is one dimensional and non-empty. And one, in that case, essentially this is because elliptic rule, so this is zero. And this is free for some m. People, and I cannot find a difference, so, but this is, I think, one can do. And keeping this in mind, I consider this one. This is nothing but restriction of relative canonical. So this is upper semi-continuous. With respect to base space. But because sigma stable, the vibration is sigma stable, so this must be constant. Because jumping up locus is preserved by sigma. So then just we have this is locally free with base change property. So taking tensoring residue field become cohomology. So considering support in case kappa is zero or two case, zero or two case, this is one dimensional base space. Goes to Copperbell. This is the union of base locus, and this is sigma stable. And this is contradiction. And in the second case, again, this is we have base change property. So kappa is one case. We have what to with respect to this one, we get vibration. Sorry, this is E, all E, sorry. something S. We have relative vibration with respect to this one, with respect to this one. But this is everything is sigma stable. So we have sigma action. But then, then what? Then this is a surface. So this implies S is abelian. This is relatively anti-canonical one. This must be abelian. But then irregularity of this is greater than or equal to 2, this is 1, and contradiction. In this way, we can exclude this case. And finally, dimension one case. I have no time to exclude all, so I just prove zero entropy. And actually, and is one case. So if again this is a smooth vibration and we consider relative Albanese and all irregularities are constant for the same reason as before. This is because smoothness, just smoothness. Then, if it is positive, then we can consider relative Albanese map and contradict to the irregularity problem and so on. Just a moment. Sorry. I made a mistake. sorry. This is two. So, sorry. This. I'm sorry. This is not true. This is that. This is coming from minus relative anti-canonical map. So this is elliptic vibration. So, but then x is not covered. And contradiction. Sorry. And so, and relative Albanese gives, in this case, contradiction to irregularity. Relative Albanese. And if positive, then we have this. But here we have action, and this is then abelian. This contradicts so finally, we reduce these are all zero case. And in this case, because of Kastelnuber criterion, all ST are rational, become rational. And Now, consider here a relatively minimal model problem, and this is threefold. So essentially, three cases we have, right? Then modify a space case, but this is at most three, because this is three dimensional and cubic form divided by product of hyperplane, so at most three and sigma stable. So may assume sigma stable. Modify a space from X.
Number.
Yes. This is. So may assume this is sigma stable after replacing sigma. Number. We may assume this. Because this is just three. Which part? This is I think you are expert. assumption is almost no assumption. This is three, four. Because then we have this cubic form. Cubic form, and here we have this space, and this is modified by space. So this is codimension one, pullback of, and. For this space, this is codimension one hyperplane. And on this space, cubic home is vanish zero. Cubic home is zero. So we write this equation x1. Then this must divide out this cubic home, because this is over here, this is cubic home is identically zero. And so, at most, I think this is. And sigma stable. So if dimension y is 2, then y is again abelian, but this is contradicted to irregularity one. And if dimension y is one, then we have originally this is modifiable space. So this means minus, this is elliptic curve, and minus kx is pi ampere. Because this is modifiable. So previous argument, this plus high pullback gives contradiction. Because then x becomes abelian variety. So this gives contradiction. So this case is easier case, and so now time. And then then we consider this is only divisorial contraction. And it is easy to see that all divisor goes to curve and dominate here because this is smooth vibration. And if this is sigma periodic, this exceptional is sigma periodic, then contradiction because wild, sigma is wild. So, sigma period. This is birational contraction, extremal contraction. And because this is a smooth threefold, so only divisor goes to curve or point. But this is a smooth vibration, so this always goes to curve. And anyway, we have this. And if this is some multiple of sigma preserves this. If then sorry. And so essential part case is not and yes and I'm very sorry. This case we have no elementary argument and finally we attribute again Legendre-Ultras work. Legendre-Ultras work, which I wrote down from now. First non-finite regeneration also inspired by Legendre-Ultra. But this also appeared Legendre-Ultra and this noticed by Legendre-Ultra availability. And, and so in that case, X, threefold. this is Legendre. projective threefold. And so, and and what he considers is assuming positive entropy, assume positive entropy. Then, then there are several cases from this structure of X. There are several cases and dividing into several cases, kx is nef case, then blah, blah, blah. But we don't need any information about this, so I forgot. Second case is kx is not nef. Then we have first case is we have modified per space case, but this case we already excluded. And then a birational case. Action case. And then there is again two cases that exceptional is F periodic. And this case, again, some structure, but we don't need it. And finally, exceptional. Not F periodic. And in this case, he gave precise structure. This is a theorem. And I wrote this and finish. Star. he proved. We have here f, and there is some pi. This is birational, and this is both smooth. And here we have S. This is smooth surface. And also here we have same surface. And this is rho. This comes from Hilbert scheme. And such that we have extension here, and also reduction here. Some blow up, and then we have this. And this is under the assumption. This assumption is crucial in this. Under the assumption, very surprising part, one can control something even in this case. This is what Legutra did. And but then E and pi. We transfer E by iterate of Fn. Then it make several intersections, and what he proved is that intersection is actually some finitely many curves, and then blow up of that part, and blow up of that part is this part, and this is ruling part. And this part is constructed by using Hilbert scheme argument. So this is actually controlling intersection is very important. After and to do this part, this kind of ruled surface. This is smooth threefold control. Maybe I forgot one more case to go to point, but this we don't need it. So. Sorry. And in this way, he constructed this kind of things. But then, if our sigma is positive entropy, then we should get these pictures. We should get these pictures. But then, this is wild. So, and this is just birational. So this also wild. Then this become wild. But then S become abelian surface. But this contradict. Because irregularity is the same. This is birational. So at least so sigma is zero entropy. And further ruling out this case, I studied really scheme theoretic generic fiber of this vibration and developed intersection theory over there to finally find the counterexamples. Finally, impossibility. Thank you very much. Abu Calabia? If example exists, more interesting. And One reason why I started to take a look of paper, Keras and so on, is to find some other way to consider this problem. Not your reference scalar. Kira, sorry. ring theoretic. And also. Classification. This is completely classification. Variable. Yes. This is by three authors. And classification is so in which sense classification is difficult. But this is last time you very much complained my writing. So I try to. A is abelian variety. And so then sigma is always written down as translation and automorphism of group. In this setting, sigma is wild. This is equivalent to say that beta is nilpotent. So, for example, and now condition B, beta B, this is all inside A, and this is group generated by subgroup generated by this. And then taking Zariski closure,
yes.
Then this becomes A.
Yeah, this is a characterization
word.
We have classification
word. More precise
yes.
No.
There are very different cases.
I think for lower dimensional. Over C and abelian variety, for example, surface 3-4. Elliptic curve case, this is nilpotent, is same as tau is.
But translations can be different.
And infinite order.
Yeah, but there are different kinds of infinite order translations.
Yes.
Yeah.
That is translation, and translation part is non-torsion. This is what kind of non-torsion? This is highly non-trivial.
Yeah, this is non.
No, not non.
Not non.
I did not know.
But maybe there is some result of it.
About ring.
Yeah, it's
twisted. I did not know.
If x is any dimension, larger than 3, and it has wild automorphism, is it possible to show x cannot be uniruled?
Abelian variety is not uniruled.
But it says a conjecture. The conjecture says if it's wild, then it's obedient. So there's a conjecture?
If wild, wild automorphism, existence of wild automorphism implies abelian variety is a conjecture.
Is it
can you prove that?
Can you prove?
No, not in
your. Yeah. this, yes, this is a good question, and we want to try, but still threefold case. For example, I use, so far we use some, this is essentially threefold, so very far, still very far. Mm.